is very simple. We have elucidated very plainly what our demands have been. That we want to live in a country that gives us land.
Yeah.
We want to live in a country where it gives us education.
Yeah.
We want to live in a country where children will not die from natal diseases.
Yes.
Tomorrow is an exercising, it's a forward march in our annals of history.
Forward.
Forward, comrades, forward.
Forward.
What we will be doing, and I will want to zero in and issue a very stern directive to the state organ that is the police force, that not a police service.
Mm-hmm.
If we see unidentified men in civilian clothing riding in government vehicles that have obfuscated qualities, we shall treat them as robbers.
Yeah.
We shall treat them as thieves.
Yeah.
We shall treat them as colonizers. I want to assure all the Kenyans that we have not gathered here today in vain. Viva, comrades, viva.
Viva!
We assure Kenyans that we will not see those madmen on the streets.
Yes.
We have gotten to the point in this country where we even have Caucasians wielding arms on the streets. Tutakubali sakata.
Yes.
Tomorrow, as we march towards a new republic,
yes.
Nane nane.
Yes.
Kabla ya saa nane na dakika nane.
Yes.
I want to assure you that the spirit of the Kenyan youth remains unbowed. Viva, comrades, viva!
Viva!
Viva, comrades, viva!
Viva!
Viva, comrades, viva!
Viva!
We shall march for our rights, and tomorrow we shall liberate this country. Yeah. Long live Kenya!
Long live!
In recent years, Kenya has witnessed a wave of protests led by Generation Z, aimed at addressing various grievances and notably seeking ousting of President William Ruto. Despite their energy and determination, this protest has not achieved their primary goal. Analyzing the reasons behind the failure of Gen Z movement reveals a complex interplay of political, social, and structural factors. One of the reasons why the Gen Z movement has failed to oust President William Ruto is lack of unified leadership and clear strategy. The primary reason for the failure of Gen Z is lack of unified leadership and coherent strategy. While their protests were driven by genuine grievances, they lacked a centralized leadership structure to guide and coordinate efforts effectively. Without a clear strategy, and leadership, the movement struggled to present a united front, making it difficult to sustain a momentum and pressure on the government. Point number two, government crackdown and intimidation. The Kenyan government under President William Ruto responded to the protests with a heavy hand. Security forces were deployed to disperse crowds, and many protesters faced unrest, intimidation, and violence. Some of around 100 people who were killed during the protests. The government's crackdown created an atmosphere of fear, discouraging many potential supporters from joining the movement. The state's ability to suppress dissent through force and intimidation significantly weakened the protesters' resolve and capacity to mobilize more so that they could oust the president. Point number three is economic constraints. If there was in Kenya, we have greediness. If we can bring together funds, someone will run away with it like that. So economic hardship played a dual role in the protests. While economic grievances were a primary motivator for the protests, they also limited the ability of young people to sustain a long-term activism. Many Gen Z protesters faced harsh reality on needing to work to support themselves and families, reducing time and energy they could devote to the movement. The economic strain made it challenging to maintain conscious and continuous large-scale demonstration. Point number four, political fragmentation. Kenya's political landscape is highly fragmented, with various ethnic and regional divisions influencing political allegiances. This fragmentation was evident within the Gen Z protests, where different groups had varying priorities and grievances. Lack of cohesive political message that could resonate across demographics weakened the movement's impact. Additionally, political fragmentation allowed the government to exploit division and undermine the protest's effectiveness. For instance, Raila Odinga's ODM party presented around five cabinet ministers who have been vetted and sworn in as we speak. You can now not go to the coast of Kenya and say that Ruto is not good, because the people there, they listen to Joho and they have seen Ruto has appointed Joho to be a minister. Same way as Western Kenya, whereby Oparanya has been appointed. If you go to Nyanza, you will find out that John Badi and Opio and I and the Attorney General come from that region. Now you cannot tell the people from that region that Ruto is not good. They will defend him to the last man. So that is one of the failures. Point number five, media manipulation and censorship. The role of media cannot be underestimated. But in the failure of the Gen Z protests, the government exerted control over mainstream media, limiting coverage of the protests and shaping public perception. State-controlled media often portrayed the protesters as unruly and disruptive, undermining public support. Furthermore, there were instances of internet shutdowns and social media censorship, which hampered the protesters' ability to organize and communicate. Point number six, lack of political support from established opposition. While the Gen Z's protests aimed at addressing systematic issues, they did not receive substantial support from established political opposition figures and parties, such as the ODM party. In fact, the ODM gave them several ministers, gave the government several ministers who have been sworn in as we speak now. The opposition in Kenya has often been fragmented and focused on their political agendas rather than aligning with the grassroots movements. The absence of strong political backing meant that the protests lacked necessary political leverage to challenge President William Ruto's administration effectively. Point number seven in this analysis is the international indifference. International support and pressure can play a crucial role in legitimizing and sustaining protest movements. However, the Gen Z protests in Kenya did not garner significant international attention or intervention. The global community remained largely indifferent or passive, which limited external pressure on President Ruto's government to address the protesters' demands. It is very sad that other countries followed suit on Kenya's start fighting for the economic and social liberation by the Gen Z's. These countries have successfully removed brutal regimes like that in Bangladesh, and so Kenya started the thing, but they have failed. That is something that we must learn. We started the movement and it spread across the world, but we have lost it because it's at this point of time, we are not able to outsit the president. So the failure of the Gen Z protest in Kenya to outsit President William Ruto is attributed to a combination of factors, including lack of unified leadership, government repression, economic constraints, political fragmentation, media manipulation, insufficient political support from the opposition, and international indifference. These elements combined to weaken the protest movement's effectiveness and sustainability. For the future movement to succeed, there must be a focus on building a robust leadership, strategic planning, gaining political alliances, and leveraging international support. So guys, in case you are new to this channel, kindly consider subscribing to our channel and make sure you hit the notification button. So until next time guys, I hope you are staying safe wherever you are, and see you in our next video as we embark on this journey. Thank you guys.
Mr. President, every time you speak, Kenyans find a reason to go to the streets. Niko na representatives watano, lakini bado sauti yangu haikufiki. Tuliamka mapema kuvote, lakini bado barabara ni mbaya. Sasa kazi ya kura ni gani? MPs wamelala, the only time wanasimama ni wakitaka kiti. Watu wakileleshwa mlichagua MCA ama influencer. Everything he posts is a lie. Tulisema tuoni ukifika 2027. Sasa unatupiga risasi ya macho. Ai. Sai tumeamka, unlike zamani, Muslims pekee ndo walikuwa wanaswali. Accident zinafanyika lakini president ajali. Wakenya wanalia na Mohammed Ali. Mr. President, my dead friends ndo unaita criminals. Under your government we've seen it all. Protester anapiga goon, polisi anapiga protester. Guess nani anahepa na goods? Youths walikuvotia wanauliwa tu wanakuuliza why you are not fulfilling the promises you made during your campaign. Bodies are university students inapatwa kwa kware. Imagine the parents' pain. I don't know how it feels to be born in a rich family, but I wish to ask my kids how it feels someday. Unatuita criminals but unatutafuta kwa hospitals, churches na shule. Uniforms ni expensive, si sare. Free education iliisha. Large portion ya salary inaenda kwa school fees. Yo ingine pia tunamuai Kibaki. Mi hata ukinitafutia job Uturuki, sitaki. Mheshimiwa tulipea kiti sahi atusiki. That's why we are standing up for ourselves. Minister wanakuwa overpaid na madaktari hawalipwi. While in hospitals ndio kuna working CS. Vijana hawana kazi. Kindiki, Murkomen na Duale wanatitiwa kama vyombo za wageni. Jua watolewi kwa cabinet. National Intelligence Service hawako intelligent. Wakenya wako hungry. Kila siku kuna influencer anambiana Buda Pest. Serikali iko na mkono mrefu lakini NGOs ziko na amref. Kenya police walichange jina lakini bado wanatumia force. Mr. President, even if we don't go to the streets, your guys will still come for us in our homes. Threat ya polisi ni kijana ako na flag. Ukipatana now you have to hide your flag or else you'll become a hashtag. Mr. President, when it itotla lakini project zako zina drag. How do you expect to add votes na serikali yako inatocha minus? Office of the First Lady imepewa budget ya 96 million na tumenyamaza tu. Kwani hamjaona kitu Hanifa amefanya na 30 million? Times have changed. Viongozi wa kesho tumechoka kuchagua wezi wa jana. Wacha niachane na hii theme tu nikiendelea watani mada. Mna expect aje mwanafunzi kwa wawezi afford unga ajibu maswali mboga? Graduates wanataka kuandikwa juu kwa ubao. Tuna complain drought but mvua ikinyesha hatujengi boholes na mnataka to act like things are well. Mwananchi hana doya kubai food na politician propaganda ana sell. Unatutafutia kazi diaspora na huko pia Kenyans wana protest. Ni husband aliomba loan NCBA, CBB, apeleke mtoto shule, CBC. Gava wamemuongezea taxes, CBD. Na grade mtoi anapata, CBE. Was it worth the investment? Mr. President, we left the church because of people like you. You guys build churches but not hospitals and schools. When we ask for accountability, you call us anarchists. There are no jobs. Our parents are complaining because all of us are artists. Hamwezi to divide along our ethnic lines. Sahi sisi si wa tribe all. Sini wa tribe all. Tujengeni viwanja. Masomo ikikataa vijana u tribe all. Ministry of Sports iko na mchezo. Mr. President, wa Kenya wanauliza mbona tukikukasirisha wewe unaenda kutureport kwa watu wa ushago. Kwani wao ni polisi? Wakenya wamechoka na wakiprotest wanashikwa wanapelekwa station wateka rest. Sini mang'ombe na mashida zinatuandama. Mwenye miba kidogo ndo tunaona ni the best. This has to change. Sini nyama, politicians ni masimba na Duale ndi anatupeleka kwa Aden. Kipchumba ako kwa rally anambia vijana, niteni mali mkomen. Wanatuibia kimaksudi. Huko online mwenye akona mose ni kuria. Tumelia nja hadi mkono ya right imepoa ya kupanguza machozi. Sio ya kulia. Jenzi wa Apple na Uber wameleta shida kwa nyumba. Saiki Mania and his boss wametafuta ODM wagawane ichungwa. Tunakwambia wa point technocrats but news just in zinasema Alfred ni mtu wa Ministry of Labor. Me I know, but this government lazima kuwe na docket 2 ya Churchill. We don't want positions, we want a working system. Ukitaka kudeal na problem you cut the root system. Next time ukienda kuvote beba ID kwa mkono ya right. Na akili usilevu.
Lakini sasa umetusahau.
I'm here for Kenya, I'm here for my people, I'm here for your rights. Nitoe.